by your come, my no one
is sure. Come, my no one is sure.
And Christmas time, you know, smell my heart.
Yes,
please,
Santa. You know, good time.
Yeah.
Welcome. I am Yannick.
And I am Orlando. Thank you for tuning in to the UCJCI's channel. In this week's episode, we will look on 2016.
In our Show Me Emotion segment, we will be featuring Mass Gussie of Lime Tree Lane, which is an early television series in the early 90s. He will be telling us about the birth of Jesus and reminding us a little bit of what the real reason for the season is.
We will also be getting greetings from the...
Across the world?
No, not from across the world. Greetings from our members and officers of the UCJCI.
Alright, cool. So, Lando, you ready?
Yannick, you ready? Come, journey with us on this exciting mission. I discovered this wicked pasta dish, like pasta, some Parmesan cheese, some chicken, some Alfredo, what else we put in it? Pepperoni sausage, we do that in 2016, as well as Alex's wedding and Alex and Deandra's wedding, Converse, Okay. So let's look on the UCJCI's year 2016.
Let's talk a little bit about what happened for the United Church in Jamaica and the Cayman Islands for the year 2016. As usual, we had our camps. This year was a significant year for camps in UCJCI because the numbers increased significantly. It was an amazing year for us. And we want to talk especially about the numbers for our youth camp, which was in August, and it's in August each year. The numbers grew by double the amount of last year, and we are really giving God thanks for that, and we're hoping that we can indeed build on that. Another thing that happened, especially as we talk about camps, is the fact that we had to say goodbye to one of our dear friends and brother and father in Christ, Reverend Henry Earl Thames. He will be greatly missed. We lost him at youth camp this year, and we just want to take the time out to remember him, that his death was quite impactful, and his life was even more so impactful on us as a church and as individuals. What you're about to see is a post-funeral interviews of Reverend Thames's funeral. Watch, enjoy, and thank you for tuning into UCJCI's channel.
I think today we said a lot of serious things about Reverend Thames, but there was another side of him that people just don't remember. Reverend Thames took you in his car as a female, his bag would be between yourself and him. That was part of his DNA. At camp, he would be part of the security detail, he would go around at night with a flashlight, making sure that people are not doing things that they were not supposed to do. And he was just always looking out for young people. On a Sunday after camp was finished, he made sure that there was food, a concert. He had sometimes some films that people didn't really want to watch, but they were about evangelism, so he had to do it. Earl will be missed. The one word I have for him is invaluable. He was one of a kind, and we'll never see someone like him. Certainly not in my lifetime. The church was blessed by his presence.
The challenge, of course, in speaking about Reverend Earl is that he was a man of so many parts. That whenever you start, you're going to go on for a while. In fact, on Sunday, when at Ridgemount, we tried to have a two-hour reflective event in honor of him. It was just impossible. So after it got to about 3.5 hours, we just gave up and just kept going on until it completed the 4.5 to 5 hours, and we still knew that we had not finished really who Rev was to us. The key thing about him is about how he lived such a complex life, so multifaceted he was. But when you met him, you were just meeting one ordinary, humble man. It has to be his humility that stands out, at least for me. His love for the young and his work for the cause of the kingdom, seeking every soul for Christ. have been motivated even now in his passing to further consider what are we to do as a first as an individual, as a people, as a church, towards gaining especially young souls for the kingdom of God. May his soul rest in peace, this great gentleman, the giant of the faith.
You go on and drive to
God be with him until we meet again. Thank you for the
opinion of Reverend Earl Thames was an inspiring one. We're blessed by the music, by the tributes, by the story of his life. His story is an amazing one of a bright young man who was just totally sold out for Christ and gave over 50 years of ministry to the United Church. Reverend Thames is someone who I came to know and love. I found him to be humble, to be very spiritual, to be very committed to Christ. And he used his intellect and all his gifts to the glory of God. He was totally committed to discipleship and to loving and serving young people. And you know, I think for all of us, he's a great example of what can happen when we are sold out for Christ and sold out to advancing the mission of Jesus Christ. It was a real blessing to know him, and I think this service was a great tribute to a wonderful man.
Hi guys, I'm Scott. I personally wasn't that close to Reverend Thames, but it's amazing to see all the things he's done. I've been hearing about his various contributions to the United Church, and it's amazing to see because he was such a humble fellow, he didn't really speak much. And let me just say, my fondest memory of him is at the banquet when we were there and he was serving us. I was thinking to myself, who is this fellow to be serving us? He's so above that, but he humbled himself and went down and was serving everyone, and that was a great memory that I have of him. And even though I didn't know him that much, I've been hearing so many great things about him, and he was really a giant in the United Church.
I'm one of those young adults who continued going to young adults camp up to 5 years after I passed the age for young adults, due to the fact that I loved Reverend Thames's Bible studies. So I went there 5 years after I passed 40 just to hear Reverend Thames Bible study. I mean, you learned so much, it was so applicable to daily life and to the career that I was pursuing. I just love that man. I'm happy to say he went to the greatest school on earth, which was Woolmer's. And when I got married, somehow I had left him off my invitation list, and I saw him 2 days before the wedding. I said, please come, and he came. He was such a humble man. Had a wonderful funeral. He will always live in our hearts forever.
It was a wonderful send-off for a great man, Reverend Thames. It's been a loving friend to my father and family for many years, and it was really a privilege for me to be here with him and to have shared with him at camp. The service was very touching and very, very, very well done. The tributes were very wonderful and to the point. He was really a great man, and I'm glad I was here.
Reverend Thames, he was really a special, special man. He had such a heart, such a humble heart. And, you know, during the service, when you heard of his great accomplishments and everything, it just really made you marvel, but it just showed how much he loved the Lord, and that was his greatest prize. So it was wonderful to be here, and we just pray for his family because we love him, so we can only imagine how much his family must miss him. So we just ask God's blessing on them.
Nicole Bramwell, I am the eldest niece of Reverend Earl Thames, and we just want to say we're just so overwhelmed by the expression of love and the love lives that have been touched by him, ministering to people, young and old, and we just come together just saying thank you so much for what you poured out on us as a family, even without knowing us and just knowing us through our dear Uncle Earl.
Hi, I'm Karen Parchment, one of Uncle Earl's younger nieces, and I'd like to thank everybody for coming, everybody's very kind words and the tributes. They've meant more than words can express to all of us, and for that we thank you.
Hi, I'm Alicia Parchment. I'm Reverend Earl James' youngest niece. I'd like to thank everybody for coming today. It means the world to my family and I that everybody was so touched by his life and had such a and that he had such a positive impact on everybody, including all of us. So thank you so much, and we know we'll be greatly missed.
Hi, I'm Danielle Bramwell. I am the second to eldest niece of Reverend Earl Timms. I want to commend and just express my appreciation to Jamaica, our home country. They have shown us so much love, and my uncle so much love over the years and through this tough time. And I want to say we love you and thank you all so much.
Lando, do you remember when I moved to Shoreline Training from JBC?
What is a JBC?
Yes, you're serious, right? No? My youth at that TVJ used to name, but at them time that we saw the proper cartoon like Thundercats and Tom and Jerry.
Yannick, you remember which year we born?
Lando, I'm not in the
month. No, ask which year we born.
Read Lando. Lando, which year were you born?
90s, which means we don't know nothing about these things. I know not what is a JBC.
Anyways, JBC was what we now call TVJ, and what I really want us to get into is about Mass Gussie, who is going to be telling us a little bit about Christmas. He used to be one of the characters on Lime Tree Lane.
Oh, right. yes.
So he's going to be telling us a little bit about the birth of Jesus Christ.
Okay, come, let's hear from Mass Gussie himself.
Hey, how you do? Yes, man, this is me, you know. Remember me? My man, you know, friend, Mas Gussie. You know, just want to bring us little greetings, you know, at Christmas time. You know, it's at Christmas time, you know, when people give a lot of, they give a lot of gifts, and they eat and drink and party and all those things, you know. Yes, man, family meet together, and they go to church and then sing Christmas carol, then go in the street and then dance and then buy and then shop. I tell you, see, man, you know. But I wonder if anybody really stopped to think about the real meaning of Christmas. Eh? You know the real meaning of Christmas? Some people never read the Bible, you know what? I have a Bible here, man. I want to talk to, you know, from the Bible, man. I'm going to read something from the Bible here. Because see, if I can see good, you know, the glasses kind of dark. The eye dark, and the glasses dark. You will see the thing, so. Mm-hmm. But anyway, I want us to read a little Christmas story so we can remember what this thing is all about, man. Yes, man. Say, let's see, you know, a reading from Matthew. The book of Matthew, chapter 1, and we start at verse 18. When I get to the Bible and read it, me know. Mm-hmm. It say, when Jesus Christ, you know, was born the little mix up here, no. He say, no, the birth of Jesus, was at this wise. When, as his mother Mary was exposed to Joseph, and we say, you know, he was going to get married to him, the birth of Jesus was at this wise. When, as his mother Mary was exposed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. And that was the problem, was, you know. She and Joseph didn't plan to get married. Mm-hmm. And see, she pregnant. And Joseph couldn't understand how that could happen. And what the Bible says, she was fine. She was pregnant by the Holy Ghost of a baby. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. And they go on to say, no. Then Joseph, her husband, that the husband to be, you know, was a just man. And not willing to make a public example, was minded to put her away. Mm-hmm. But while he thought on these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. The angel could talk to Joseph himself. Yes, man, it's a big thing, this, you know, miracle, man, I go on here, so, And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Yes, sir. And it goes on, and we jump down here, so. And the Bible says they never get married, they never sleep together at this such time, you know. And it says, yes, you know, chapter 2, no. No, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east, saying, where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen a star in the east and have come to worship him. And when Herod the king heard about this man, he wouldn't get jealous and he get frightened because him think he was the only king. Mm-hmm. Yes, man. So when the wise men them come now, and Herod talking about where is he that is born king of the Jews, Herod couldn't understand that. And he get to him get him say, but wait, king of the Jews, but me is king already. But I was looking for Jesus, who they say was king of the Jews, man. Sorry. And so him get vexed and frightened. And say, boy, you know something? I want to go and worship that king too. So him tell the wise man, them say he must go try and find out where him is. Because he want to worship him too. But you know what he want to do? He want to kill him. Yes, man. And so the wise man then go. And them see Jesus. But they never go back and tell Herod nothing. They were told not to go back. They never go back. And so Herod gets so vexed, man. And then kill off all of the picking them. Well, and that too. Especially the boy picking them because he was so upset, man. And so that is just part of the story of Jesus. And them try all kind of things to get rid of him. But Jesus was born to save the world. And so none couldn't kill him. He would have to grow until he become a big man. And then they crucify him on the cross for the sins of the world. What the Bible say? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So listen to me now. As we talk about Christmas, and celebrate Christmas with a hum and drink and party and all those things, remember that Christmas is about the birth of Christ, the Savior of the world, coming into the world to save the world, because everybody born in sin, and God wants to save them. You don't want nobody to go ahead. And so sent Jesus, the Son of God, to as a babe into the world. So as we sing and go to church and dance, just remember that. And what we need to do, is to accept Jesus Christ as Savior. It's long time, you know, I preach this thing, you know, long time we hear this thing about Jesus coming to the world, joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let her receive the king. They don't blow a whistle. Hey, hey, not go on. But let me tell you something. Remember this. It is a fulfillment of prophecy. Fulfillment of scripture. So, as you know, go join the family dinner and all of those things. But as you prepare for the first coming of Jesus, you must get ready for the second coming. And that is just around the corner. You see, the whole of things are gone here. People are killing people, earthquake, people are killing off picnic, all kind of bad things are happening. The Bible, they don't prophesy these things, that these things were to happen in these days. It's the last days. As a matter of fact, Jesus could have come before Christmas, you see. So now get ready. Love one another. Care about one another. Love your neighbor as yourself and do something special for somebody every day, man. Anyway, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Until as soon as I get here, this mass gossip man wishing you all the best for this year until I through the new year. Yeah? All right. Again, Ha ha. Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Mas Kossi. Anyway, it's my time now. So, I'm going to send Christmas greetings to my mother, my grandmother, my cousin, my skip.
And that was greetings from across the world. And
as I'm today,
we'll now have greetings from the members and officers of UCJCI.
Hello, season's greetings from Donna and the Northeastern Regional Mission Council Office.
Season's greetings to all. This is Lorraine, and I'm wishing you a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. God's blessing.
Hello, this is Annie, wishing you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year coming from the United Church Synod Administrative Office.
This is Sheila Ascott Smith of the Synod Office, wishing a blessed Christmas and a prosperous New Year to the members of the regions and to the wider United Church. Wishing you God's richest blessings.
I want to wish for my staff in the Council of the Northeastern Regional Mission Council a Merry Christmas. Also the staff at the Synod Office here, 12 Carlton Crescent, very Merry Christmas to my hardworking ministers and lay pastors, all the congregations in NERM. Merry Christmas to you all and to the wider United Church. I wish you a blessed season. God bless from Henry Sam.
Hi, I'm Robert Stevens. I serve as the General Secretary of the United Church in Jamaica and the Cayman Islands. I wish for you a joyful and peaceful Christmas or Advent season and a better 2017. It's been a challenging year for the church, but we have survived and we give thanks for God's blessings to us. Thank you for tuning into this station and I trust that next year you will continue to be part of this community. Bless you.
We have come to the end of another exciting episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. And don't forget to join us next week for another exciting journey.
Don't forget to subscribe. And you can subscribe by clicking the subscribe button that's right below. And visit our website at theucjci.com. And you can also follow us on Facebook at The United Church in Jamaica and the Cayman Islands. Again, I am Orlando.
And I am Yanni.
Have a happy and safe Christmas. Walk good. Understand that we ain't playing, we just wrap it up. Let's get it on.
We did it! Yay! Bellissima, we did it!
Wait, compliments to my, where the hat? Go buy the hat from. Compliments to my Christmas heart, his hut. It heart were hutted from the North Pole.
You don't know. Big up Santa.
And Mrs. Claus.
Mr. Elf, not Shelf.